Okay, honey, I got you a special present. It's a special DVD that my mom used to watch with me when I was sick, and now I'm gonna watch it with you.
First of all, I'm not even sick. I'm sleeping. It's 3 a.m. That's when people normally sleep. Also, I know what a DVD is. Also, I've seen this.
Nope, it's an old tale way before your time. It has fencing, fighting, giants, and monsters.
It's The Princess Bride. I've seen it like 3 times.
Stop interrupting me and put your mask on.
Mask? I'm not even sick.
But I am. Let's pop this in and watch it. And I want you to know that everyone ends up happy in the end, and the Princess Bride rides off into the sunset.
That's the part I don't get. So why is it called The Princess Bride? I get that she's a bride, but she's never a princess. Unless, are you a princess if you're about to marry a prince? She wasn't born a princess, at least I didn't think so.
Stop interrupting.
You know, Shrek is better.
The Princess Bride is not something I grew up with, which seems to be the experience most people have with it. I only saw it in high school, and at the time, it didn't feel too groundbreaking or original. I came from the generation that had Shrek, Enchanted, and Hoodwinked, and so many others. All were parodies of fairy tales, a field dominated by Disney since the beginning of film. Of course, The Princess Bride had influences elsewhere, like Zorro and The Adventures of Robin Hood, but I guess I couldn't figure out what exactly it was going for. It had a few jokes and fourth wall breaks, it had a narrative device where the grandpa read the story to a young Fred Savage and would interrupt at different points of the plot. It was also pretty straightforward, having all the tropes you'd find in common fantasy, and not playing it up nearly as much as I was expecting. So I put it aside, considering it to be just average, and not as good as Rob Reiner's other work like Stand By Me, This Is Spinal Tap, or A Few Good Men. Reiner is one of the most important directors of the 80s, but his name isn't as famous as Spielberg or Scorsese, but he deserves to be regarded as highly. The Princess Bride is often considered his best work, a notion that usually confused me, since it didn't feel as complex or fresh as his other works, but revisiting it for this review, I've come to appreciate it so much more. It's based on a novel from 1973 by William Goldman. The book itself was meant to mix several different genres into a new fantasy adventure, which included commentary throughout that added comedy, but it made for complicated attempts to adapt it to the big screen. After many years, Rob Reiner got to work and made this timeless masterpiece. In the land of Florin, Buttercup has a farm boy, Wesley, answer to her every need, and as they fall in love, Wesley seeks out his fortune so they can get married, but after leaving on a ship, he's attacked and believed to be dead. Years later, Buttercup is arranged to be married to Prince Humperdinck, the worst name for any character ever, but is kidnapped by Wallace Shawn, a giant played by Andre the Giant, and Inigo Montoya, whose father was killed, and if he ever finds him, he is prepared to kill the murderer. They run into a masked man, who saves Buttercup, reveals his true identity, and wants to free her from the doomed marriage. This always felt like yet another fairy tale, but done in 1987. At the time, there was a resurgence in the fantasy genre, while Disney was failing to put out anything like their previous successful princess movies. In the 80s, Disney animation was close to dead. The Princess Bride pretty much is exactly the kind of film that would have been made by Disney, and in a lot of ways, it's influenced the next 30 years in animation, as their future releases had more humor and meta-commentary. I realize now that The Princess Bride did a lot of stuff before anyone else. It's weird to watch it after growing up with so many countless comedic fairy tales that make fun of the tropes. I'm sure lots of people who saw it at a young age simply took it as a common love story adventure. Seeing it as an adult, I see a lot more of what it's doing. It's surprising the audience by taking the classic story beats we know, but flipping them upside down or messing with our expectations. The masked man fights Inigo Montoya, but Montoya is not presented as a typical bad guy, but as a swordsman who respects the others he fights. The prince is a shallow dirtbag, but it's his assistant Rugen who is the true mastermind of evil. The story gets interrupted by the grandfather when the scary parts happen, and there's so many incredibly memorable lines. They might have the largest collection of quotes any person can recite at any given occasion. As you wish, have fun storming the castle, my name is Inigo Montoya, you killed my father, prepare to die, inconceivable, marriage is what brings us together today. I've heard them all so many times, but it's what makes this movie have such a strong identity. My original issues simply had to do with the amount of humor presented. It never felt too funny or satirical to really stand up with the other great parodies or comedies that have been based on adventures and fantasy. However, I now realize that this was never meant to be anything more than a timeless fantasy adventure with a few quirky characters and funny moments. I didn't respect the simplicity when this was just trying to be something like The Wizard of Oz or Star Wars or The Nightmare Before Christmas. It's so simple, well-paced, and just good. It doesn't need to be anything more. It's not like I watch Frozen or Moana, see the comedic moments, and question why the whole movie isn't a parody, because it's just adding levity for enjoyment. In a lot of ways, they owe a lot to The Princess Bride, who showed that you can have fun with the concept and take something that's been told so many times before, but make it unique. I love the look and the music and the performances. Cary Elwes portraying himself as half-limp as they storm the castle is still incredibly hilarious. And Billy Crystal, who's almost unrecognizable as Miracle Max, all his stuff is very funny. There's something for everyone to enjoy here. This really is a once-in-a-while movie that any person of any age can watch and love. It works for kids as a classic tale, and has that extra humor to keep the adults entertained, while having so many enthralling and epic moments. I can now say this certainly is Rob Reiner's best work. Special thanks to Anna for this Patreon request. Thanks for watching the video, and special shout out to Anthony, Anna, Kirsten, Lucas, Ryan, and Robert for the support on Patreon. By joining my Patreon, you can get exclusive videos and blogs, and for only $7, you can request your own movie review. I hope you stick around, cinephile, and have a happy, productive day.